Moving on, we look at Salman Rushdie, and I was talking to you about the shift that ensued with the coming of Rushdie, or something that is called as Rushdieth, developed with the publication of Midnight's Children by Salman Rushdie, and it ensued an era of postmodernism, fantasy, and also magical realism. Now, magical realism is again a term that was coined by Franz Rowe. Now we look at Midnight's Children, which is actually open various avenues of literature in the international scenario, and in fact it raised the bar with regard to Indian literature. Now, as we all know, Midnight's Children is again a novel wherein Salman Rushdie used his magical realist, a novel introduction into novel itself at that particular point of time. And Salman Rushdie won the Booker Prize for his work Midnight's Children. And later on also, he went on to winning the Booker of Bookers. You have the central character of Midnight's Children is Salim Saini, who is the narrator and also the protagonist. Now, I'll just give you a list of these characters at the very beginning, just so that you don't confuse yourselves. In case you don't know the plot line or about Midnight's Children, you can just make a note of it, because this is a very important novel. So, Padma is the present lover of Salim Saini. Salim Saini is the protagonist, as I told you already. He has another counterpart who was born at the same time when Salim Saini was born, is Siva. Adam Aziz, he is Salim Saini's grandfather. Naseem is Adam Aziz's wife. You have Mumtaz or Amina Saini, who is Salim Saini's mother. Ahmed Saini, who is Salim Saini's father. And Brass Monkey or Jamila Saini. Jamila Saini is basically Salim's sister, a singer. And you have Parthi, who is Salim's wife and also a witch. We go to the plot now. Salim Saini is actually a person who was born at midnight. And when the novel begins, Salim Saini is 31 years old and he thinks that he would die. Salim decides to tell his life events to Padma before he dies. He goes back to the time when his grandfather was in Kashmir. He basically starts telling Padma the story now. And now we're starting with the story, which is inside the larger narrative. So it's basically a frame narrative also. In 1915, in Kashmir, Adam Aziz, who is the grandfather of Salim Saini, is treating Naseem. Now, Naseem is a woman who is constrained by the Islamic traditions, wherein Adam Aziz, he treats this woman Naseem only by way of looking through a small hole. And it's later on, day the World War I ended, that is the day when Adam Aziz actually sees Naseem. And they both fall in love, they both get married, they give birth to 3 daughters and 2 sons. Emerald, which is one of the daughters, who is a very important character, and of course Mumtaz. Adam, he starts following the ideology of Abdullah, this one group of sect that starts believing in Abdullah. So Adam Aziz also believes in Abdullah. After the death of Abdullah, Aziz, he tries and safeguards one of the men or the secretary in the basement. His name is Nadir Khan. He gives him a shelter and he tries to protect him. Naseem does not like this act of Adam Aziz. And also Nadir Khan, he falls in love with Mumtaz. And they both secretly get married. But then it has been 2 years since they've got married. She's not become pregnant yet. So this actually worries the father a bit. Emerald, who is the sister of Mumtaz, she sends a message that she is in love with a Pakistani general, Zulfikar, and that she will get married to that person. Now, this actually frightens Nadir Khan and he flees the place. He vanishes. And Mumtaz, she marries Ahmed Saini. Ahmed Saini and Mumtaz, they both get married and they shift to Delhi. Mumtaz, she changes her name to Amina Saini. Because she's married to Saini, she also changes her name as Amina Saini. Amina Saini actually becomes pregnant. And they go to a fortune teller. And the fortune teller tells them that they both will get a boy baby who will not be old. And he will have 2 hands and 2 noses. As the events progress, Ahmed Sinai's industry being destroyed by a number of terrorists, Ahmad Sinai and Amina. They both together, they go to Bombay. They buy a house which belongs to a British man called Williams. And Williams employs a person, Willie, to just entertain these people by acting out funny characters. Willie is, he has a wife, Vanita. But Vanita is also pregnant at the same time, but she's pregnant because she has an affair with William, and the child actually belongs to William. Vanita and Amina, they both are pregnant now, and they give birth to babies at the same time at midnight on August 15th, 1947. So that is the time when India attained independence. So that is when these kids are born. And the nurse at the hospital, she interchanges these kids. And also, she later on regrets, and in fact, she joins the household of the rich kid, Salim Sinai. Salim grows up and he realizes once that he has magical powers. He has the power of telepathy. And that's how he actually realizes that there were 1001 kids that were born at that particular time, midnight 1947, when India received independence. These children, these 1001 children are midnight's children, and they all have magical powers. Now, out of these 1001 children, there are only 581 children who actually live till the age of 10. Salim realizes that he has also got interchanged with this Shiva, who is the other midnight's child. He has the ability to fight. He is a person who is very strong physically. Salim, in an accident, he loses one part of his finger. You have a blood test that is being taken in the hospital. Because he's lost his finger, he needs blood. And that is when it is revealed that Salim Sinai could have never been the son of Ahmad Sinai and also Amina Sinai. Now that's how they get to know that he is not their son. Now he is sent to his uncle Hanif's house to be under their protection. Salim comes back to his parents, and soon after he comes back, Hanif also commits suicide. Because the whole family is depressed with the death of Hanif, this nurse who is actually working as a maid, she comes up and reveals the truth that she was the one who had interchanged the. And because of a number of turn of events, Salim shifts from one place to another place. And in a bomb blast, family members, they all die. When he wakes up, he actually finds him in a camp of the Pakistanis. And also because of the accident, he has lost his power of telepathy. But he has attained powers. One is the power of sniffing. The other thing is that he loses his consciousness. So these two things happen as a result of the accident. And the Pakistanis use him as a sniffing dog in their camps in Bangladesh. Suddenly there's another turn of event wherein he goes to a forest with his friends, and then he is bitten by a snake, and that is when he realizes everything about his past except his name. Only he does not know his name, but then he knows everything else about him. And as and when the story progresses, he actually meets another midnight child, who is Parvati. Parvati is basically a witch. And also she falls in love with Salim Sinai, but then Salim Sinai does not accept Parvati. Because she is a witch, she actually lures him into having a baby, and also he is impregnated by Salim Sinai. Parvati, she loves Salim Sinai, and on June 25th, 1975, midnight, they both get married. That is the date when their son is born, Adam Sinai. Moving on, you have emergency being enforced in the country. Salim Sinai and Parvati get separated. Shiva is actually sworn in as the major of the Indian army. And Shiva kills Parvati and takes Salim, because they are on a mission to destroy all these midnight's children. And the 581 midnight's children were found out to be imprisoned. They were all imprisoned because of Shiva. Now he was the person who actually found out these 581 midnight's children. These people are kept till they lose their magical powers, and once they lose their magical powers, they are set out. And there is an election, and then Indira Gandhi, she does not win. The rules change. Salim is freed, and then Salim comes out and he goes to a place in Bombay, and he goes to eat starts, and that is when he realizes that it is the same test with which Mary, the servant, and that's how he goes to a factory wherein the gatekeeper is Padma. He again falls in love with Padma, and Salim Sinai's son, after 3 years, he speaks, and the very first word is abracadabra. As soon as he says this, he finishes the story, and also he vanishes into thin air. So that is the story of Salman Rushdie's Midnight Children.
Thanks a lot for watching. Do remember to like, share and subscribe.